So I've done a video pretty similar to this in the past when I called out MLB Network for their top 100 players list, but I wanted to do an official video comparing Aaron Judge to what many consider to be the best players in baseball. I'll be using 6 stats that have no possibility of being biased. We'll be using on-base percentage, slugging percentage, weighted runs created plus, weighted on-base average, defensive runs saved, and WAR. Now, there are a couple players that I could forgive one for putting ahead of Aaron Judge. Doesn't mean I would do it, but like I said, I could forgive one for putting ahead of him. Those stat comparisons will be more so towards the end of the video, and we'll even be putting Judge and Mike Trout head-to-head in the stat comparisons. And there's a pretty crazy stat that I'm going to drop on you guys comparing the two. With that all out of the way, one last thing. Make sure you guys are following Yankees Avenue on all social media platforms, Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, and of course, here on YouTube. With that all down and out of the way, let's get into the video. Okay, so starting off with a series of Astros players that many might say Aaron Judge is not as good as, let's do some stat comparisons comparing him to Jose Altuve. Now, this is over a 3-year span since Judge was a rookie. Let's compare. On-base percentage, Judge. Slugging percentage, Judge. Weighted runs created plus, Judge. Weighted on-base average, Judge. Defensive runs saved, Judge, by an absolute landslide. Now, Judge is an outfielder. Altuve is an infielder. They are different, but I mean, the difference is ridiculous. 45 defensive runs saved for Judge, -3 for Jose Altuve. And WAR, despite Judge only playing 369 games, Altuve's played 414. Aaron Judge still beats him in WAR 18-16. Are we having fun yet? Because I know I am. All right, next up we have George Springer, and just like the Altuve comparison, on base percentage, Judge. Slugging percentage, Judge. Weighted runs created plus, Judge. Weighted on base average, Judge. Defensive runs saved, Judge. And we're comparing two outfielders right now, 45 for Judge, 10 for Springer. And WAR, same deal. Springer played more games, Judge still beats him basically by a landslide in WAR 18-13.9. Moving on to the final Astro, and who in my opinion is the biggest sack of shit in all of baseball. Let's go. On base percentage, Judge. Slugging percentage, Judge. Weighted runs created plus, Judge. Weighted on base average, Judge. Defensive runs saved, Judge. Now, WAR, Bregman does edge out Judge. He played 100 more games. If the amount of play was the same, Judge absolutely passes him 100%. The fact that it's even close is pretty ridiculous. Next up, we have another player who a lot of casuals automatically assume is better than Aaron Judge when it's really not the case at all. On base percentage, Judge. Slugging, Arenado does beat him out, but overall offensive value, weighted runs created plus, Judge destroys him, 157-130. Weighted on base average, Judge wins again. Now for defensive runs saved, Nolan Arenado, he's considered to be one of the best, if not the best, maybe next to Matt Chapman, defensive third basemen in baseball. Judge beats him out 45-40, but honestly, I'm just gonna call it equivalent. They're both really, really good defensively at their position. And lastly, we look at WAR. Despite playing over 100 less games, this is just amazing. Aaron Judge, more WAR. He's been more valuable than Nolan Arenado is, who a lot of people consider to be hands down 100% better than Aaron Judge, but clearly that isn't the case. Moving on to the best shortstop in baseball and another player that people automatically assume is better than Aaron Judge. Let's do it. On base percentage, Judge. Slugging percentage, Judge. Weighted runs created plus, Judge. Weighted on base average, Judge. Defensive run saved, Judge. WAR, Judge. Once again, despite playing 90 less games, Judge edges him out in WAR 18-17.7. Now, you guys might be noticing a trend. Does this video sound very repetitive? It's not my fault that it's very repetitive. Aaron Judge is just really good, so blame him. Don't blame me. Moving on to Freddie Freeman, one of the main players that I was really pissed off about, MLB Network ranking ahead of him. Let's do the comparison. On base percentage, Judge. Slugging percentage, Judge. Weighted runs created plus, Judge. Weighted on base average, Judge. Defensive runs saved, Judge. WAR, once again, despite playing a lot less games, Judge obliterates him in WAR 18-13.6. Another player commonly assumed to be better than Aaron Judge. Now, he entered the league in 2018, so of course, we'll take the stats from 18-19. Still, on base percentage, Judge. Slugging percentage, Judge. Weighted runs created plus, Judge. Weighted on base average, Judge. Defensive runs saved, Judge. WAR, despite playing, what is that, 40 less games, 50 less games, 9.7 for Judge, 9.3 for Acuna. So yeah, so far it's really not even a contest on who's the better player out of the guys I've named so far, which is very ironic because like I've said, everybody considered, or most people, casual fans I should say, consider these guys to be better than Aaron Judge. That clearly is not the case, but now we're going to get into the players that I can maybe forgive one for putting ahead of Aaron Judge, and then Mike Trout at the very end, who obviously is better than Aaron Judge. He's the best player in baseball, arguably the greatest player of all time, or on his way to be. But yeah, let's get into the four players that you can call better than Judge. All right, so first up, we have Christian Yelich. Now, he qualifies under one of the guys that I could forgive somebody for putting ahead of Judge, mainly because he's been a totally different player over the last 2 years. So let's go through the offensive comparisons. means on base percentage, Judge, slugging percentage, Judge, weighted runs created plus, Judge, weighted on base average, Judge. They are very, very close. And keep in mind, 2017 Christian Yelich was a totally different player. But still, regardless, look at the defense. Aaron Judge, 45 defensive runs saved. Christian Yelich, I feel like not many people know this. He's a negative defender, negative 13 defensive run saved. That plays a big part in this comparison. What I always tell you guys, a player's value stems from their ability to create and prevent runs. Yelich does an outstanding job of creating runs, but in the category of preventing them, Judge beats him out by a mile. Now, of course, WAR, Yelich has played more games, so he edges out Judge 20-18. Same deal as Bregman. If they played the same amount of games, which they didn't, you can't take that away. If they played the same amount of games, Judge is easily equal to him, if not more. But yeah, Christian Yelich, he's up there. One of the players I'd forgive you for putting ahead of Judge. Would I take him ahead of Judge? Absolutely not. Next up, we have Cody Bellinger, who is almost as good defensively as Judge. Not quite, but close. Let's do the comparisons, though. Offensively, on base percentage, Judge. Slugging percentage, Judge. Weighted runs created plus, Judge. Weighted on base average, Judge. Defensive runs saved, edges him out by a little bit, 45-39. And WAR, despite, this honestly surprises me because Cody Bellinger is coming off an MVP season. Despite playing, 80 less games, Judge beats him out in WAR 18-15.4. But yeah, I'm not going to say they're not close. If you took Bellinger, I could understand. I'd absolutely take Judge. But like I said, these players, they're all in the same group of high-tier elite players that you really can't go wrong picking any of them. All right, last player before we get into the Mike Trout comparison and who is reasonably considered to be the second best player in baseball. Can't go wrong with that opinion. Let's do the comparison. So over the last three seasons since Judge's rookie year, on base percentage, Judge, slugging percentage, Judge, weighted runs created plus, Judge, weighted on base average, Judge. Now defensively, Mookie Betts is one of the few players you could argue is better than Aaron Judge defensively. 64 defensive runs saved for Mookie, 45 for Judge. Now, of course, Judge has missed time. If they had the same amount of playing time, it'd be a little bit more close. Mookie Betts would still edge him out. Keep in mind, though, Judge, he is on the rise with his defense. He led all right fielders in defensive runs saved with 20 last year, despite playing only 102 games. They're pretty close. Defensively, though, I'd say you got to give the edge to Mookie Betts. Now, WAR, Mookie Betts is at 22.4. Aaron Judge is at 18. Once again, the fact that they don't have the same amount of time played, that plays a big part. Put it on an equal playing field, Betts still probably edges him out slightly, mainly because of their base running. Once again, these two players' offensive and defensive impact is very, very similar when they're both healthy. Betts, though, he does edge out Judge in base running, so if you want to pick him as a better player, honestly, it's totally understandable. For me personally, if you told me both guys are going to be healthy for a full six-month season, like you know that for a fact, I'm 100% taking Judge. I believe his offensive peak is higher than Betts, and I think defensively, they're basically equivalent, like I said, when healthy. So, I mean, I would take Judge over Betts, but that's just me. Okay, so just for fun, I'm sure you guys have been waiting for this. We're gonna quote-unquote compare Mike Trout and Aaron Judge, but you really can't, besides one stat I'm gonna drop right after this slide. But let's just do it. On base percentage, Trout beats him by a landslide, 447 to 401, slugging 634 to 572. This is really crazy, because Judge's stats are insane, and Mike Trout's are just so much better. Weighted runs created plus, 184 to 157. Weighted on base average, 440 to 405. Defensively, Judge is definitely better, but I mean, WAR, this is what's crazy. Look at the games played, pretty damn similar. Trout crushes him in WAR, 25.2 to 18.0. But as for those games played, take a look at that. This is the stat that I'm about to drop. So I tweeted this out the other day, and follow me at Dan Allen Rourke on Twitter if you don't already. But over the last three seasons, Mike Trout has averaged just six more games per year than Aaron Judge. Which, first of all, some people on Twitter were taking that tweet the wrong way. By no means am I comparing Aaron Judge to Mike Trout. Like I said, Trout is on the way to being one of, if not the greatest baseball player of all time. But the narrative that's so forced with Aaron Judge, not completely false, but really overblown, is that he's injury prone, he can't stay on the field. But Mike Trout, he's only averaged six more games per year than Judge. Nobody puts that narrative on him. Nobody puts that label on him that he can't stay on the field. And a lot of people's response to that when I clarify is that, oh, Trout's so good that it doesn't matter. So my reply to that would be, so what you're saying is just because a player misses time doesn't mean he's not impactful when he is on the field. That's clearly the case with Mike Trout, and I just showed you guys the stats with Aaron Judge. That's clearly the case with him too. What have I always said to you guys? He is the most impactful player in baseball offensively and defensively next to Mike Trout. Maybe sneak Mookie Betts ahead of him, that's fine, but you cannot tell me Aaron Judge is not at least a top five player. I'd say it's even a guarantee when healthy, Judge is a top three player in all of baseball. Okay, so I really hope you guys enjoyed that video. I was kind of bored and I wanted to make a more official video of the MLB Network being called out video. And I think we did a pretty good job explaining how good Aaron Judge is. This is a movement, guys, and I take a little bit of pride in saying I generally think I've had an impact on people's opinion on Aaron Judge. I think a good portion of Yankee fans that say underrated him or were calling him out, I know a couple of you guys have changed your mind. I mean, how could you not considering the stats provided? Bottom line is, when healthy, Aaron Judge, he is one of the best players in baseball. And guys, appreciate his prime. I know one of my biggest regrets, not regrets, but things I look back on and wish I could have experienced is A-Rod's prime. One of the greatest Yankees of our generations. I was too young to fully experience that. I'm not too young to experience Aaron Judge's prime. So appreciate him. We want to see him on the field every day. Root for him. Don't bash him. Guys, this is the face of our franchise and really the face of baseball. And if we don't act like it, who really should? So yeah, that's gonna do it for this video, guys. Hope you all enjoyed. I'll see you guys next time. Let's go, Yankees. Her body's gold like September. She burns through the night like an ember. And all those things we try forgetting, I remember. But we say we are fine, we are fine. Sunny day dreams and we up now. Vodka lemonade, I serve it up, it goes down.